Hello everyone, my name's Emma and I'm the Chief Scientist at Izon Science, and today I'll be giving you some tips on how to optimise a TRPS measurement in order to get the best quality data. Today we're using an Exoid and an MP100 nanopore. It has already been wetted and is ready to be calibrated with CPC100s. Following nanopore setup, we have loaded the upper fluid cell with CPC100 particles, and the average blockade size is roughly 0.2 nanoamps at a baseline of 108 nanoamps. This is at a voltage of 1400 millivolts, 600 pascals pressure, and 47 millimeters stretch. While this is perfectly suitable for a calibration, you can adjust the parameters to get a better signal-to-noise ratio and therefore better data. Signal-to-noise can be improved in three ways: reducing the stretch, increasing the voltage, or reducing the pressure, as each of these will result in an increase in the relative blockade size. However, there are some things you will need to consider when doing this. The stretch increases the chance of blockages occurring, increasing the voltage comes at the cost of potentially increasing the noise, and decreasing the pressure reduces the particle rate, making measurements slower. This makes setting your conditions an important but delicate balancing act before you begin. By decreasing the stretch to 46 millimeters, increasing the voltage to 1500 millivolts, and reducing the pressure to 400 pascals, the average blockade size of the CPC100s is now 0.3 nanoamps, 50% higher than before. If you are aiming to measure small particles, this will typically involve working at lower stretches and higher voltages. These higher voltages, however, may increase the RMS noise. To overcome this, you can increase the molarity of your electrolyte. For example, using double strength PBS will allow you to work at lower voltages and overcome any potential noise issues. Because increasing the pressure decreases the signal-to-noise ratio, one thing to watch out for during the multi-pressure calibration is the size of your blockades at the highest pressure. This will be 400 pascals higher than the first pressure applied. So during the ready to calibrate step, it is a good idea to check the size of your blockades at the higher pressure to see if they are still larger than 0.2 nanoamps in size. Lowering the stretch to 45 millimeters and increasing the voltage to the maximum of 1600 millivolts improves the blockade size to 0.4 nanoamps. But this lower stretch has a higher risk of blocking, which may require intervention to achieve a successful measurement. The change in signal observed is different for each nanopore. For example, when changing the stretch from 47 to 46 millimeters, the last nanopore changed the blockade size by 0.1 nanoamps. However, on this second nanopore, the blockade size changes by 0.3 nanoamps. While we advise beginners to take measurements at parameters that result in a baseline of 100 to 140 nanoamps to get the best data, once you have a good understanding about what to look for and how to tune your parameters to the sample you have, you will be able to identify and work at the parameters best suited for your sample. Please contact us at support@izon.com for more information or if you have any questions. Thank you.